Set the lights in. Wait a minute, Mark hasn't voted in on
President, if the commission recommends a missile other than MX, would you go along with that recommendation?
I'm happy to say this is a photo opportunity.
I won't take any questions.
Lights, please. Thank you.
Dr. Hicks.
Hello there.
And Mr. Ruffner.
Hello there.
Well, I think you're all supposed to come over and gather around and I sign a piece of legislation.
Let you all surround them.
Do so much to ensure that the hearing impaired and other disabled persons with speech difficulties will have access to essential telephones and other specialized equipment. And I think it's going to be a big step forward for those who have those handicaps. And it will also provide informative labeling regarding the compatibility of the equipment with hearing aids. And widespread support from the various organizations representing the disabled as well as the industries involved. And without talking anymore, I'll sign the bill. There. It's law.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
Well, listen, pleased to do it.
Happy New Year from all of us.
Yes. Well, Happy New Year.
We know how busy you are, and this is your first working day of this new year that you received us all, but we think this is a very important thing. It's going to do a lot for disabled people. We're glad that you gave it the support.
It's one of the first items of business for 1983.
There's only the one thing they did wrong after a holiday, that kind of having the holidays come on the day they come, that the first day back should also be Monday.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Sure. She, as his assistant, would like very much to have one of the two on.
Thank you, sir.
Time bars.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, as one of your appointees, I would say, leader in the field of disability, I'd like to say that I think that you show extremely strong executive leadership by signing this bill. These are the most vulnerable population in the United States, and they're the toughest-minded people and have the greatest spirit and energy of any people I know in the United States. And I'm very pleased you were able to do this for us today. Yeah. It's a good way to start off the new year, sir.
There is a school of the hearing impaired in Jacksonville, Illinois. And my final college football game was played against Illinois College there. And there was a preliminary, the high school, that school and a high school in the area, it was high school level, played their game before our game. And I
coached football 6 years over at Fulton, Missouri, and played the Illinois School of Jacksonville each of those 6 years.
Well, I want to tell you, seeing that high school team up there, though, from that school for the hearing impaired, I found myself kind of happy that I I was going to be easy and play against the college team.
Mr. President, Dr. Hicks is vice president of Gallaudet right here in town.
Delighted to be here.
That was a rough, tough football team. But a lot of spirit that day. We all, knowing we were going to play, we'd all gotten dressed early so we could watch the game.
Right.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it very much.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Again.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Another league over here. I'm still trying to get back our Eastern time.
Mr. President, please, before you open the vote.
Too late.
Just a preview of what's going to happen over the next couple of days. This morning, actually, to give brief introductory remarks, David's going to take you through what we hope is coming towards the final part of the budget. But we're into the real mud cutting, which I think from a
make the Harris impression that so many of your predecessors